迎回到《时政有约》。美国副总统哈里斯目前在我国进行3天的访问，这是继上个月美国防长奥斯汀后到访我国的美国最高层级的领袖。
拜登政府上任不到1年，美国领导人就相继出访东南亚2次。
我们早前呢与新加坡巡回大使陈庆珠教授进行了访问，陈教授也曾担任新加坡驻美国大使长达16年。
听听他对于拜登政府与东南亚加速交流的动作背后有什么战略意义。
Usually when you talk of the Asia policy, America's Asia policy, you generally think of the Northeast Asia policy. For America, Asia policy is Northeast Asia policy. Southeast Asia doesn't get the same sort of emphasis or priority. Now, the United States now has been to Japan, the Republic of Korea, and China.So now it's Southeast Asia's turn. And I'm so glad that they have come. As the Vice President said in her press conference just earlier today, that it is a reaffirmation of the U.S. interest in the region, American commitment and interest in the region. You know, the United States has been in the region of the Asia Pacific for the last 70 years.And during the 70 years, they have created a context and environment of peace and security and prosperity. And all of us, you know, in the region, including China, has benefited from this. I think they don't want to lose those equities. And now with the renewed competition, the tensions between U.S. and China, the competition, I think both powers are trying to, you know, influence andwin friends in the region.
副总统哈里斯之前就出访了欧洲和拉丁美洲，那么首次到访东南亚的他为何选择会把新加坡设为到访的第一站呢？
哈里斯在结束新加坡访问后呢，明天将出访越南，成为第一位到访越南的美国副总统，这背后又有什么含义呢？
The Vice President has chosen to come to Singapore as his first stop, and Vietnam is the other stop.Now, Singapore is a long and enduring and reliable partner of the United States. We have a very long, you know, economic ties and relations. In fact, U.S. American cumulative investments in Singapore is about $428 billion. There are 5,000 American companies in Singapore creating jobs for, I'm told, more than 200,000 people. But the defense and security relationship has been a very major one indeed. We are considered a major security cooperation partner of the United States. So the reasons why they come to Singapore are so clear and obvious. We are a reliable partner and a long-standing partner. Now, Vietnam is interesting. Every country is trying to cultivate Vietnam. Vietnam shares a border with China. You know, they've been playing a balancing game very well. In May this year, Chinese Defense Minister Wei Fenghe visited Vietnam. This was followed in July by Lloyd Austin, the U.S. Secretary of Defense. And I am told, you know, I read that Secretary General Chung invited President Putin to visit Vietnam this year as well. And the Vice President Kamala Harris will be visiting Vietnam after Singapore. So they are in a good geostrategic location. And I think it's a question of also trying to influence and keep the Vietnamese relationship, all countries.
新美两国多年来建立了良好的军事关系，我国在2005年成为了美国的主要安全合作伙伴，2012年新美两国升级为战略伙伴关系。
我们就和巡回大使陈庆珠教授了解两国可以如何进一步的加深防务合作，为区域和平与稳定携手做出贡献。
Now, we've worked well with them. Going forward, I think there's a lot to do.In military terms, military technology improves all the time. So you can purchase more assets, and you need training, and you need the know-how. But I think seeing what's happening in Afghanistan, there is a lot to do. I think the, you know, we should be far more vigilant against terrorism. And I would say, I am sure the United States will be working with regional countries to deal with, to make sure terrorism does not spread so easily. So terrorism was one area. Cybersecurity is another area. And that's for the stability of the region. Also, humanitarian disaster is one area we've worked together with the United States and other countries. And given the extreme weather these days, climate change, there's a lot of work in that area.
除了军事合作，新加坡和美国其实长期以来也有紧密的经贸合作关系。
随着经济转型，新兴领域的冒起，我国要如何把握机会，加强与美国企业的合作，在未来经济里继续分到一杯羹呢？
For most of the economic relations of the United States, the private sector carries it. And private sector investment in this region is high. Certainly, you know, as I mentioned earlier, Singapore, you know, gets about $428 billion of FDI, foreign direct investment. In fact, Singapore is the country which has received the largest share of all the American investment in the ASEAN region. And American investments in Singapore are more than their combined investments in India, ROK and China. So that's how much they have here. But it's private sector, and we work with the private sector. I think there is a new partnership announced, which is a growth and innovation partnership between Prime Minister and the Vice President this afternoon at the press conference. And I imagine that must be led by the private sector. Certainly you can go for some rules, you know. We are hoping the United States would be interested in doing a digital economy agreement with ASEAN. That would certainly, you know, work out a lot of the rules in e-commerce and so on. So there's a lot we can work on.
美军近日撤离阿富汗造成的混乱局面，让撤军行动蒙上了阴影，更引发了各国重新审视美国在全球所扮演的角色。
那么美军撤离阿富汗是否会让美国在印度太平洋区域所扮演的角色起任何的变化？陈金书教授针对这一点做出了以下的分析。
Now, the rationale for withdrawing from Afghanistan, President Biden and his officials have been quite open about saying that they would like to withdraw from Afghanistan so they can refocus on the Indo-Pacific, on Asia. But I think they can't forget Afghanistan, since with the unfolding events there, we've seen what is happening. That will distract them for a bit. But I think the United States is interested in focusing on Asia because they see their rising competition from China in this region. So what can Singapore do in this? Singapore will do what it has in the past, you know. We are offering facilities, you know, they can use our air and naval bases. And we train in the United States. That's a big plus for us because we have such limited territory, and not many countries will allow you to train on their land, in their territory. So this is very important for us. But at the same time, we also want to be friends and are friends of China. So we are trying to keep this balance.
谢谢我国巡回大使陈庆珠教授。
我国和美国在2004年签订的自贸协定，是美国和亚洲国家缔结的第一个自贸协定。往后，新加坡和美国经贸关系将如何发展？锁定稍后的节目。